I recently bought some 7-segment LED displays for another project that I was working on, my breadboard computer. And as a little side project, because that was getting a bit tricky, I got interested in the way that the pins are wired up on these displays. Single-digit displays work kind of like you'd expect. There's one pin for every segment of the display that you light up. But I've discovered that the multi-digit ones, like these 4-digit ones, work in a rather surprising way. I thought they would have a pin for every segment, but they don't. They still only have sort of, how many pins have we got there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We've got 12 pins on there. And so I started doing some research into how they work, and I got wondering whether you could drive them from a micro bit. I found an excellent project on the Raspberry Pi TV website that explains how to drive one of these displays from a Raspberry Pi using Python. I thought I'd have a go and seeing if I could drive one from a micro bit using MakeCode instead of Python. Now, you can get LED displays like 7-segment, 4-digit LED displays for the micro bit that work much better than this. So here's one that you just connect up to one data pin, and it uses serial data, and it's got a little basically a microcontroller in here that does all the encoding for you. It's very clever because you can send it text. It's very easy to make projects with this, but I got interested in finding out a little bit about how you could drive a 4-digit display with all those segments, 7 segments in each display. How can you drive it using only that small number of pins? And the answer is you have to kind of multiplex the display. So you've got pins to wire up each segment, and then you've got 4 more pins which select which individual LED is lit at any given time. If you want to have a go at making this yourself, what you need is a micro bit. I've used a version 2 micro bit, which gives you one extra pin, spare pin, compared with the first version of the micro bit. Some sort of breakout board, because you need to get up more pins than you can get at just using crocodile clips. You're going to need quite a lot of pins for this. And probably a breadboard, some jumper wires, a display, and some resistors. I've been a bit cautious here. I've used 330 ohm resistors because I happen to have a packet of them lying on my desk. The display is a little bit dim, so you probably could use a slightly lower value resistor. I've gone with 330 ohms because they were here and I'm being a bit cautious. I looked at the data sheet for this display and it said it needed about less than 2 volts forward voltage. So we needed to drop the voltage a little bit, so you could do some calculations to work out precisely what value resistor you need. But I just sort of was over cautious, put 330 ohms in. Kind of works. What I've made here is a timer program. So basically, if I press button B, it counts up, and if I press button A, it counts down, and it will flip over 9999. So it goes up and down. So it's a very, very simple program, but you could use this equally for building I don't know, like a stopwatch or a clock, all sorts of things like that. I didn't wire up the decimal points in order to save on pins. So let's have a look at how that works. So here's that Raspberry Pi TV page that I was telling you about, which does a really good job of explaining how these displays work. And here's the pinout for that 4-digit display. As you can see here, these pins here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 11 and 10, are the pins that drive individual segments of the display. I didn't use pin 3 because I was trying to save pins on my micro bit. So you basically connect those to a voltage via a resistor, and you can light individual segments of the of that particular digit. You choose which digit you want to light, however, by grounding these pins 12, 9, 8 and 6. Now, this is really weird. It does sound like it says here, how can we use this? That's impossible, because it would mean that you have the same digit displayed 4 times. So how can you do that? Well, the answer is you kind of need to multiplex the display. So you need to switch very quickly between digits showing different things. And that's what I've done. So I'll show you, first of all, how I wired up my micro bit. I use these pins here. Now, one of the pins that I used is also used for the display. So I had to turn the display off. There might be other ways around that, but it's just the breakout board that I had forced me to do that, because I needed all of these pins. This is the number of pins you need. I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You need 11 pins to drive this display. 7 of them for the digits go via a resistor. The other ones, which are the control pins, which select which digit you're lighting at any given time, don't need a resistor. So you're just going to write those to binary 1 or binary 0. directly. Let's have a look at the MakeCode project for this. So I've got a counter in this project that counts up and down whether you press button A or button B. So we set that to zero at the beginning of the program, and I turn the display off because I'm using one of the pins that doubles up on the display. Doesn't work if you don't do that. And I've got a subroutine called MakeString. Now what the MakeString does is it converts the counter basically to text and pads it out. This is not done in a particularly elegant way. It's a bit of a sort of brute force coding to pad a digit to a string that is four digits with leading zeros, depending on what the counter is. So that's the MakeString. Then the main business of the program is in a forever loop. Now I have put my code inside a while true loop inside a forever loop. The reason for that is forever loops in MakeCode on the microbit put in a small delay, and normally that's a good thing because it enables you to see or hear whatever it is you've just done. Here we want to run our code a little bit more quickly than that, so if you put a while true loop inside a forever loop, it gets rid of that delay and it runs much faster. I've put in here a couple of tests to see whether button A or button B is pressed, and put the counter up by one or down by one depending on which button I pressed. And then this is the business part here where I select the digit. So first of all, because you need to ground the pin 14 on the marker bit, I've got connected to the select pin for the first digit, so I'm going to ground that and put all the other ones to high. So now when I light all the segments of the LED, it will show on the first digit in the display. I then do it on the second with the second part of that string. So we're slicing up the string. I've got a four character string with my number in, so it's zero index, so zero is the first digit. So that's showing the first digit. This is showing the second digit, and I've grounded pin 15 this time. Then I ground pin 16 for the third digit, which is sliced up here. And then finally, I ground pin 10, which is what I used for selecting the final digit. And this is the bit of code that slices up the string to give you the last character. Let's have a look at how the actual display of the character works. So I have written a subroutine. This is quite a long subroutine called digit, and you pass it a number, and depending on what the number is, it writes different pins high and low. These are the pins that are connected to the segments, to the LED segments on the display via a resistor. So these are just lighting individual segments. It's completely arbitrary which pins you use. I happen to use this particular selection of pins here to light each individual segment on the LEDs, which are all numbered. So every segment has its own number, as shown over here in the yellow. So it's completely arbitrary which way you do it. That's just happens to be the way I chose it. I found in the forever loop, I did actually need a very small delay after each digit is displayed, otherwise it didn't show up. But it's really important you put the same delay after you display every digit, so that's in there four times. If we make that delay a bit longer, you can actually see the multiplexing in progress. It's not what you want on an actual display, but you can see it happening. So there we go, a little project to drive a four-digit, seven-segment LED display directly from a microbit, just using some jumper wires, a breakout board, and some resistors. It's quite instructional, quite educational. I've learned a lot about how LED displays worked. I didn't know they were multiplexed in quite that way, and it's quite fun to actually write your own code to do the multiplexing and get it to work. And it's quite intriguing to see that you can do this in MakeCode just as well as you can do it in Python.